You're listening to episode 24 of the Decorate Like a Design Boss podcast. On today's show, I'm talking about rugs. This episode is for you if you've struggled with size and style of rugs, or if you've been stumped on what pattern to select, or even what type of rug to buy. I'll be covering in this episode why some rugs cost what they do and when it's appropriate to abandon ship and go for an inexpensive rug that will get the job done but won't break the bank. Let's get started. Welcome to Decorate Like a Design Boss, a podcast for design lovers who want to create beautiful spaces in their very own homes. My name is Kimberly Grigg, and I'm a professional interior designer who teaches design lovers like yourselves how to decorate. And when I say decorate, I mean decorate like a design boss. If you're ready to create a space that your family loves and your neighbors can't stop raving about, well, buckle up, honey, because it's time to design. Well, hello there, my design lovers. I am so glad you're here, and I have a question for you. Are you comfortable and confident in your decorating skills? Design is a complicated, layered process, and it has many moving parts. Do you struggle with certain aspects of the overall process? Do you become easily overwhelmed with all of the details? Do you wonder, where do I start so that you can achieve success? Are you unsure of how to accessorize and finish a project? Well, if any of these questions are keeping you up at night, then I have the perfect solution for you. My Insiders Club membership gives you over 100 hours of video training on every aspect of interior design. You also get my course on the fundamentals of interior design. Without the fundamentals, it's really a lot like math. You just can't move forward and have the right foundation to make your home all that it can be. And you also get a live virtual group training session with me and a consult included in that virtual group training each month. So check it out over at KimberlyGriggDesigns.com. All right, well, let's dig into today's topic and learn all about how to choose the right rug for your spaces. There are very few elements in your decor that have the decorative ability to tie a room together as effortlessly as rugs. Whether it's the inspiration for a space or it's a finishing touch, a rug can bring that special element to a space that packs a lot of punch. Selecting a rug, however, can be daunting and overwhelming, and it has its fair share of limitations and challenges. But if you can understand these factors, such as material, size, and style, chances are you'll have a seamless experience making the perfect selection. So, first things first, let's talk about the fibers that rugs are made from. Without getting all textbooky, I'm going to highlight these fibers for easy reference. First, there are the natural fibers. These include things like wool, cotton, jute, sisal, and silk. And of course, there are others, but these are just the most common that you need to look for. These are the priciest of rugs, and there are some cautions associated. However, if you're looking for luxury rugs and investment rugs, search for ones made of these fibers. The pros about this type of rug? Well, they're durable and long-lasting. Wool can also be extremely good at hiding soil. Cons? Well, they're pricier and require professional cleaning. Silk rugs can also be very sensitive to water spills and high traffic. So next, as a category, we have the synthetics. These include polyester, polypropylene, olefin, acrylic, nylon, and viscose, to name a few. These rugs are less pricey and are a perfect match for high traffic areas. They also work well for pets, young children, and, well, your budget. Pros: easy to clean and stain resistant and very affordable. Cons: well, they're just not as luxe looking and feeling as some of the natural fiber rugs. There is another qualifier of rugs, and these categories consist of hand-knotted and machine-made. So that's two different categories. The first is hand-knotted. The second category is machine-made. Hand-knotted rugs are for sure more expensive and luxurious and are usually made of the natural fibers. A lot of these rugs are also hand-dyed and hand-knotted in Turkey and other faraway places. Man-made rugs are made from synthetic fibers and are typically more budget-friendly and are mass-produced in a variety of styles and patterns. Both types of these rugs have varying quality, sizes, and price ranges. So, how do you know which type of rug is right for you? So first, you want to assess your style and the mood that you're trying to create. If you love a grand, luxe look that is very layered and rich, you might prefer a luxury style rug that is hand-knotted, made of natural fibers. But if you have a more casual and relaxed vibe and mood, then a machine-made rug of synthetic fibers might be the perfect choice for you. I advise that you also identify your lifestyle and your traffic patterns. If you have pets, young children, and high traffic, then the synthetic man-made rugs might be right for you. Synthetics are not a bad word or a bad choice, by the way. There are some very good simulated rugs in the marketplace today. If your rug is to be a statement piece and is considered an investment, then you'll most likely want a rug made from natural fibers, and those are typically hand-knotted. So your aesthetics, of course, will weigh heavily on what type rug you'll choose. There are rugs in both hand-knotted and natural fibers, as well as synthetics, that will fit each and every style. I break these styles down a bit in a generalized way. Traditional rugs include Persian, Oriental, Moroccan, Berber, and even antique and vintage pieces. Contemporary rugs include mid-century, and you're looking for pieces as well as geometrics, coastal country, and farmhouse style rugs. There's also natural casual style rugs such as jute, sisal, sheepskin, leather, and cowhides. Bohemian type rugs include shag, kilim, duri, southwest, and ikat. All of these types can be obtained in both natural and synthetic fibers and a slew of sizes. Identifying which style is best for you is a personal preference, but I use these general guidelines as a starting point. First, consider your overall mood and feeling, and of course your budget and traffic pattern. It is also good to consider the colors that are included in your space. Once you know this, I like to assess what the room needs. Is the room mostly filled with solids? If so, maybe a little texture or even a pattern is appropriate. If your room is busier and has a lot going on, well, then maybe a rug with less pattern might calm things down. Is the room fairly neutral? Then you can add a textural rug or a rug that has a pop of color. Is the space just not coming together, or you feel the need to tie things together? Well, then a rug can be a fantastic way in accomplishing this feat and is typically going to be a patterned rug. Now it's important to talk about the pile of a rug. The pile of a rug means the density or the thickness of a piece. Rugs that are coarser will have more pile to them. Low pile rugs have shorter fibers and loops and are often referred to as flat weaves. These are perfect for high traffic areas such as kitchens. They also are great if tripping is a factor. High pile rugs have fibers that are taller and looser, making them more plush. These types of rugs are great for bathrooms, bedrooms, and/or living rooms. The pile of a rug is both a performance and an aesthetic consideration. Next, we'll want to consider the size of the rug. One way to measure for a rug is to measure the room overall. Then take off 1 to 2 feet all the way around and get a rug that covers this much floor space. When I'm working on creating groupings within a space, or if I'm working with a tighter budget, I prefer to purchase a rug that will house all four of the legs of the pieces of furniture that will fit on top of this rug. Sometimes I purchase a rug, especially if it's a vintage piece or a must-have and is size limited. Then I will at least have the front legs of the furniture to fit on the rug. I never select a rug that won't accommodate at least the front feet that will appear on top of the rug. If the front feet won't fit on top of the rug, well, you're getting a rug that is too small. Recently, I had a client who asked me to help her select the perfect rug for her space. She showed me photos of what existed, and the first thing I said was, well, your existing rug is way too small. She said, no, it fits just right. I said, well, it might fit, but it's doing you no favors. She insisted until I said, I'm not ordering that rug that we love in that size because it's the wrong size. I suggested that she go home and use painter's tape to tape off the rug size that I was suggesting. She reluctantly agreed. I kept stressing over and over that I was right. I wasn't trying to get in an argument, mind you, with my client, but I knew this in my designer heart of hearts, and I often see people make this same mistake. I passed her off to another designer in my office for her opinion. The designer said the exact same thing that I said, and I promise this was not a staged response. She went home and taped off the size and agreed to let me order the rug in what I felt was the more appropriate size. And the end result? Well, the room immediately looked larger, and of course, all of her other rugs then looked too small. We ended up replacing all of her rugs and repositioning a couple of them. This is a very common mistake that people make when trying to determine the appropriate size. You simply start measuring off the space in between the furniture, and when this happens, you're buying a rug that's too small. Just remember, a larger rug will trick the eye and make the space look larger, and it will promote a more luxurious space no matter what fiber that you're using. Most people also get the dining room rug size wrong. Most tend to forget that the chairs will need to easily slide on and off of the rug or back, hopefully, on top of the rug. The inability to do this is very frustrating. So to get it right, use this formula as a minimum size guide. Add 24 inches at least, but preferably 36 inches to the dining room table measurement all the way around. I also encourage people to use a synthetic, low pile, even flat weave rug under dining tables when possible. This way, the chairs slide easily on and off the rug, but the synthetic fiber is easy to clean if there are food spills. You can access my free rug guide in the show notes or over on the website at KimberlyGrigDesigns.com/podcast. This little guide will help you determine the rug size that you need. You might ask at this point, well, all right, I got this rug size thing down. Do I need a rug pad? The answer is, quite simply, yes. It is rare that I don't use or include a rug pad. A rug pad helps you protect your floor and helps your rug withstand the test of time. Rug pads also help prevent slipping. I like to use a plush rug pad with a synthetic rug as it adds an instant up level to the overall look. Just as a side note, if you have a pet who is attracted to your rug, then consider replacing the rug pad fairly often, as it's the rug pad that typically absorbs the scent and odors of the pet and not actually the rug itself. Often, you can get the stain and smell out of the rug, but it will linger in the rug pad. Another note about pets. If you're considering jutes or sisals in a natural fiber, but you have pets, please note that these fibers are basically a type of grass. Pets are very attracted to them. Many are prone to soil a rug made from natural fibers, even when they are fully house trained. Others love to chew and gnaw them. So instead, consider the plethora of some very good synthetic fibered rugs. I will list some sources in the show notes, but I use one from a company called Surya all the time that looks just like a jute and or a sisal, but it's made from a synthetic fiber. Just as another side note, I use sisals and flat weave grass fiber rugs as an underlayer on more formal rugs all the time. This is a way to have the feeling of luxe. Also, it stretches the size a bit, but it sort of dresses down the formality in a space. So this is the one of the very few types of rugs that is layerable. And when I mean layerable, I am often asked, can I layer a rug on top of another rug or layer a rug on top of a carpet? And the answer is no. However, you can layer a rug on top of a flat weave rug with success. So finally, let's talk about the care and cleaning of rugs. Basically, spills and mishaps are unavoidable. Knowing your fiber is the most important part. For synthetics, try spot cleaning, steam cleaning, and or vacuuming. For wool, try blotting and then use a toothbrush and dish soap, a dish soap like Dawn, to blot. Don't scrub as it breaks the fibers down. Cottons and silks, well, you're going to need help from a pro. So what can we learn from today's lesson? Rugs are an important tool in the design mix. They create a sound buffer, provide a softness to a space aesthetically, and they're beautiful. Rugs can be an important unifier, and if incorporated correctly, can also be an important feature in the design mix. Choosing the correct fiber based on traffic flow and style is a key factor in getting your rug right, as is purchasing the correct sized rug. If you need help selecting the rug size, well, check our show notes and then head to KimberlyGrigDesigns.com/rug size guide and download my free guide to how to choose the correct and perfect size. So, I encourage and invite you to send me your own questions that you have about decorating your home. I'll be featuring some of these questions here in hopes that your design dilemma or challenge might help someone else along their design journey. You can send me a question at Kimberly@KimberlyGrigDesigns. I'll also provide this information in the show notes. And today, I have a question related to rugs from one of my listeners named Chelsea. Chelsea says, I have wall-to-wall carpet in my living room. It's not my first choice, but I cannot afford to replace it currently. Can I layer a rug on top of this carpet? So here is my answer. I say this is very tricky, Chelsea. Unless your carpet is more of a flat weave, then the rug will constantly roll if it's placed on top of it and have puckers in it. This can result in becoming a tripping hazard, and, well, that situation just tends to always end up looking messy. Rugs definitely help tie a room together, but in this case, I feel like it's best to use other elements as your unifier. If you have a sisal or a flat weave carpet on the floor, then yes, you can layer a rug on top, as the flat weave will lay flat and almost serve as a rug pad for another rug to lie flat on top of it. Otherwise, the answer for me is a hard no. Sorry, I've just not had success with this type of layering. Okay, my friends, that's it for today's lesson on rugs. Keep those questions coming, and don't forget to follow, rate, and review this podcast. I so appreciate the love, and I'll be back next week with another exciting episode. But until then, I like to say, don't wait. Today is a great day to decorate. Bye for now. Thanks for listening to Decorate Like a Design Boss. If you want more info on how to decorate your space like a pro, visit KimberlyGrigDesigns.com. See you next week.